remember in 2012 when we started the parties, we were a little bit scared at the beginning, and we always used LGBT party because we were too afraid to say lesbian and gay party, because then we thought, okay, then everyone knows what we're talking about. And then, but we realized quickly that the government was leaving us alone, and yeah, more and more locals were coming, so we started promoting as lesbian and gay, and now it's all out in the open.
You know what solution, you know, they take you out.
LGBT ကိုယ်ကိုယ်နေကြတယ်လေဒီတန်းနေကြတယ်ဟိုပုံရှုပ်ခွင့်ရှင်တွေရမှာရှင်ဒါပေမဲ့2017လေးနောက်ပိုင်းမှာကျတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဒီ LGBT အခွင့်အရေးလောက်တဲ့လူတွေကအဖွဲ့အစည်းတွေပေါ်လာတော့လှုပ်ရှားမှုလောက်လာကြတယ်ပညာပိတ်လောက်လာကြတယ်လူတွေကတိလာတယ်ဒီလူတွေရှိတယ်ဒီလူတွေရဲ့
identity ကိုနားလဲလာကြတယ်တိလာကြတယ်ဆိုတော့နောက်ပိုင်းဒီ LGBT ကိုယ်တိုင်ကလည်းကိုယ့်အကိုဟိုသူ feel confident ဖြစ်ပြီးတော့ come out လောက်လာကြတယ်ပြီးတော့ရှင်သူ out and proud ဖြစ်လာကြတယ်ပေါ့နော်သူပြင်ဒီအငယ်လေးပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဖြစ်လာကြတယ်
The space and we've explored the space as a community to do more events like this, which are kind of quite big and quite public. So I think, yeah, we've created a dialogue about it, and we're just interested to see in this kind of new phase for Myanmar.
What the future holds in terms of the LGBT rights movement. Well, yeah, look, Yangon discrimination, look, I don't know. Still, she don't know society discrimination is stigma, that's been a new zone, she didn't know about family, mother, she is society, she is county, mother, she is the state, guy, is sponsored out of the discrimination, so she needed the law, but not the Myanmar, the people, don't know, she needed the law, but not the British, Colony, Kit, Lao, don't like, she get it.
Okay, there goes the main guy running about in glitter. Yeah, I'm super positive. You know, I think the transition Myanmar is going through right now, I hope that also gives a positive boost to the LGBT community here. Oh, oh, oh.